At the Institute for Molecular Bioscience, we dare to imagine a world with a cure for every disease. Think about it, 100 years ago, the life expectancy for the average adult in America was 50. In that 100 years, we've gained 30 years of life expectancy. And so what we've begun to see over the last few years is a change in the bacteria that exist in the clinic, and they're becoming resistant to the antibiotics. And that means our modern medicine is actually threatened because people will become susceptible to infection. And so what we need to do is we need to start developing new ways of treating people with infections and new antibiotics to treat people with infections. We have a multi-pronged approach to trying to tackle antibiotic resistance. The first thing we're doing is we're going back to nature to try and find new medicines that will work against these antibiotic resistant bacteria. Most people don't know that we don't invent medicines by little scientists with molecular hammers in the lab. In actual fact, nature inspires most of our medicines. We're interested in how bacteria actually exclude antibiotics. So they have an armored coat on the surface that prevents antibiotics getting into the cell and killing the bacteria. And so we're looking for ways that we can create chinks in that armor that allow the antibiotics to get in and kill. I think it's really true within scientific endeavor that the real major advances come from serendipity. You know, if you look at penicillin, for example, and they saw it was killing bacteria in the plate, and somebody went, oh, that's interesting, wonder why it's doing that. At the Institute for Molecular Bioscience, that is the secret ingredient for the success of the building. It is bringing chemistry, genetics, and biology together to actually answer complex questions about human health and some of the other challenges that the world faces.